So today is the disappearance day of Srila Ramananda Raya, who was an eternal associate of Lord Chaitanya. As it has been described in the scriptures, that Srila Ramananda Raya was the incarnation of Visakha Sakhi. As Krishna appeared as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to release his own mellow, the conjugal mellow, to help Lord Krishna in his pastimes, Lalita and Visakha Sakhi both also appeared as Swarup Damodar Goswami and Ramananda Raya. So Ramananda Raya was a Visakha Sakhi in Krishna Leela, and Swarup Damodar was Lalita Sakhi in Krishna Leela. So Lord Krishna appeared as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to release the love for Krishna, because Krishna was the subject of love, so he could not release that love as Krishna. Only who is ashraya or the shelter of that love can release the love for Krishna. That's why Lord Krishna appeared as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, taking the mood of Srimati Radharani and the complexion of Srimati Radharani. So Lord Krishna, when he appeared as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he wanted to fulfill his three desires. One was Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima. What is the glories of Radharani's love for Krishna? Krishna wanted to understand that love. And secondly, Lord Krishna wanted to release his own beauty, own madhurya. Because Krishna cannot release his own beauty as Krishna. Only Radharani could release the beauty of Krishna as she was the shelter of Krishna's love. So that's why this is second reason that Krishna wanted to release his own beauty. And the third reason was Krishna wanted to release the happiness Radharani derived by showing her loving affection towards Krishna. So for these three reasons to release, Krishna has to accept Radharani's mood and Radharani's complexion. Radha Bhava Dyuti Suvalitam Navami Krishna Swarupam. So Krishna accepted Radharani's mood and her complexion, and he appeared at Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So to help Krishna to release this mood, Lalita and Visakha also appeared as Swarup Damodar Goswami and Ramananda Raya. And they were the constant companions of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at Jagannath Puri. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was residing at Jagannath Puri, Swarup Damodar Goswami and Ramananda Raya constantly associated with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and helped him to release that mood by always speaking Krishna Katha and always singing about Krishna's glories. So Swarup Damodar Goswami was a very good singer. With sweet melodious voice, he would sing Krishna Lila pastimes in front of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Ramananda Rai, understanding the mood of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, would speak Krishna Katha, quoting from Srimad Bhagavatam and other scriptures. So in this way, they both help Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to fulfill his desire, three desires. So the same Ramananda Rai, when he was in South India as the governor of South India, appointed by Gajapati Maharaj Pratap Rudra. So when after taking sannyas, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, following the order of Sachimata, wanted to reside at Jagannath Puri. Because Jagannath Puri is a place where one can release the mood of separation. Because Sri Jagannath, he is also in the mood of separation. Jagannath is Krishna, but he is always in the mood of separation from Srimati Radharani. That's why he has accepted this Mahabhava form as Jagannath. Always meditating on the mood of Srimati Radharani, or the separative mood of Srimati Radharani, Lord Jagannath has accepted this form. And in the same way, when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to Jagannath Puri, so he was Krishna himself, but in the mood of Srimati Radharani, he was feeling the separation from Krishna. So there are two forms. Krishna is feeling separation from Srimati Radharani, and Krishna in the mood of Radharani feeling separation from Krishna. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Jagannath, both were feeling separation from each other. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu resided at Puri. So he could fulfill this desire. So whenever Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would see Jagannath, he would see him in his Shyamasundara form. He would see Lord Shyamasundara, his worshipable Lord, in the mood of Srimati Radharani. So when Jagannath would see Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he would see Srimati Radharani in Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So that was the feeling both were exhibiting at Jagannath Puri. And during Rath Yatra, also the same mood was exhibited by Jagannath and also by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would dance in front of Lord Jagannath's chariot, Jagannath's Rath would stop to see the dancing of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And even if so many people would pull the chariot, still the chariot would not move. Even Pratap Rudra employed so many elephants to move the chariot, but the chariot would not move. But when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself came and put his head on the chariot and pushed the chariot, then chariot started moving. That was the way Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Jagannath was reciprocating with each other. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu delivered Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya in Jagannath Puri, that was a great mission achieved by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, he was the incarnation of Brihaspati. He was the greatest scholar of that time. And even Mayavadi sannyasis would come and take lesson from Sri Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave his mercy to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and converted him into a Vaishnava. He was the greatest Mayavadi scholar, but he became a devotee of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy. So that was a great news spread all around India that Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya has become a Vaishnava. And Raya Ramananda, who was a Vaishnava himself, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was initially critical of Raya Ramananda. He could not understand the Vaishnava behavior of Ramananda Raya. But when he himself became Vaishnava, then he could understand the mood of Ramananda Raya. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to go to South India, in the plea of searching for his elder brother Vishwarupa, but the actual reason was to preach Krishna Bhakti in South India and make South Indians Vaishnavas. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he left Jagannath Puri, at that time Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya had informed Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that, "My dear Lord, I could not understand the mood of Ramananda Raya. I was always critical of him. But he is a great Vaishnava, and he is the person who understands the mellow of Krishna's love. So he is the fittest person to associate with you. So when you go to South India, you please see Ramananda Raya and you will be very happy to see him." Then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted Ramananda Raya, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya's proposal. So when he went to South India, after visiting Jiyoda Nrisingha, Nrisinghadev, then he went to the bank of Godavari. So he first saw Godavari River, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu immediately remembered Yamuna. So he took Godavari as Yamuna, and the forest on the bank of Godavari was considered by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Vrindavan, Vrindavan forest. So in this way, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu remembered Vrindavan and he started chanting and dancing at the bank of Godavari. Then he crossed Godavari River, went to the western bank of Godavari River. And in western bank of Godavari, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took bath in Godavari, and then he went little away from the bathing ghat and he was sitting in the bank of river Godavari and chanting the holy name of the Lord. And he was remembering the advice of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya to Sri Ramananda Raya. So he was expecting that he would see Ramananda Raya in this place, because Ramananda Raya was the governor of South India, and specifically he was staying at the place called Vidyanagar, which was near the Godavari River, western bank of Godavari River. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to see Ramananda Raya, and when he was chanting the holy name, at that time he heard some musical sound. Then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw that so many people, they are accompanying a person and they are playing drums and bugles, and then a person is carried by a palanquin. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu could understand that this person must be Ramananda Rai. So he saw that person came in palanquin, got down from the palanquin, which was carried by few people. Then, according to Vedic tradition, the Brahmanas were there. They were reciting Vedic mantras. And then, while Brahmanas were reciting Vedic mantras, Ramananda Rai, he took bath in the river Godavari. So after taking bath in the river Godavari, then Ramananda Rai saw this effulgent sannyasi who was sitting little away from the bathing ghat. So when Ramananda Rai saw this effulgent sannyasi, he was very much surprised. He saw that the sannyasi was so effulgent that the effulgence of 100 suns were coming from his body. So Ramananda Rai was greatly surprised. Said, ordinary person or ordinary sannyasi could not show that much effulgence of 100 suns. So this sannyasi must be extraordinary. So Ramananda Rai, thinking in this way, he came near Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And when he saw the beautiful form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that he had a golden complexion and he had a beautiful bodily form and he had very beautiful eyes, lotus eyes. Then Ramananda Rai, seeing this extraordinary beautiful form of the sannyasi, he thought that he is not any ordinary human being. He could understand that who could be this sannyasi. So immediately he offered his dandavat pranam at the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And when Ramananda Rai offered his dandavat pranam, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw Ramananda Rai. Then he was sitting and chanting, so he got up. When he saw Ramananda Rai was offering dandavat pranam at his lotus feet, and he wanted to embrace Ramananda Rai, understanding that he must be Ramananda Rai. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu stood up, he was ready to embrace Ramananda Rai, but he wanted to also confirm that he was actually Ramananda Rai or not. So when Ramananda Rai was offering obeisances, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that, please get up, because Ramananda Rai was offering obeisances. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, please get up. And when Ramananda Rai got up, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked, are you Ramananda Rai? So then Ramananda Rai said that, yes, I am the most fallen Sudra, Ramananda Rai. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard this humble submission of Ramananda Rai, he was extremely happy to see him. So immediately Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu embraced Ramananda Rai. And he firmly embraced Ramananda Rai. And Ramananda Rai also firmly embraced Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And in this way, both were releasing greatest bliss by embracing each other. And then they started rolling on the ground. So then the Brahmanas who had come with Ramananda Rai, they saw from a distance that this governor of South India, Ramananda Rai, who is a very respectable personality and a great scholar, now he is rolling on the ground with the sannyasi. How is it possible? So they were thinking, what is the reason that Ramananda Rai is rolling on the ground with the sannyasi? And then they saw both of them, Ramananda Rai and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they were rolling on the ground, and in a faltering voice they were chanting the name of Krishna. Because they had the sattvic transformations in their bodies. So their voice was faltering, the hairs on their body were standing on end, and they are sweating, crying, and rolling in the ground. These are some symptoms of sattvic transformations in the body. So when the Brahmanas saw this, they were very much surprised that this sannyasi must not be any ordinary sannyasi. And they heard that both of them were chanting the name of Krishna. So then the Brahmanas, they also started chanting the name of Krishna. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw this, that they both were exhibiting sattvic symptoms, and this is not a proper place to exhibit that, because so many people are with Ramananda Rai, they are all watching from a distance. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he controlled himself. And then they both got up, and then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Ramananda Rai that actually when I was coming to South India, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya informed about you. He said that you are a great Rasika Bhakta, and it would be my great pleasure to meet you and discuss Krishna Katha with you. That's why I came to you, and I wanted to actually see you, but by Krishna's arrangement, you have come and we have met here. So this is my great fortune. I am a Mayavadi sannyasi, and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya mercifully has directed me to come to you and hear Krishna Katha from you. So Srila Ramananda Rai said that, my dear Lord, actually you have come here just to deliver me. I am a Vishayi, I am a pound selling man acting as a governor of South India, working under the king, taking money for my livelihood. So I am a Vishayi, I am enjoying, I have material propensities. So just to deliver me from this sansara andhakupa, the blind well of this material world, You have actually come here, deliver me. So in this way, both are praising each other. And then Ramananda Raya said that, you see, just by your presence and hearing the name of Krishna from your mouth, I have thousands of men with me, and they are all chanting Krishna, Krishna. So from this I can understand that you are the same Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. So then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu immediately closed his ears. He did not want to hear that he was Krishna. He said, actually, all your men are chanting the name of Krishna, not because of me, that is because of you, because you are a great devotee of Krishna. And those who are great devotees of Krishna have the power to make others become devotees of Krishna. They can make others chant the holy name of Krishna. So in this way, both were praising each other. So then Ramananda Raya said that, very mercifully you have come to me to deliver me. So please, you stay here 8-10 days and deliver me. My heart is very hard, so you make my heart very soft and deliver me from this pool of material existence. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that, actually, I am a Mayavadi sannyasi. I have come to hear Krishna Katha from you. So I would like to stay here and hear Krishna Katha from you, as directed by Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. So in the meantime, one Vaishnava Brahmana came and he invited Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to go to his house and accepted Krishna Prasad. So accepting his invitation, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went with that Brahman to his house and told Ramananda Raya that, I will be waiting there to see you in the evening, so we can discuss Krishna Katha. So after taking lunch and after taking his evening bath, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu waited in that Brahman's house. And Ramananda Raya, with one servant with him, he came in at night to see Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the Brahman's house. So when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw Ramananda Raya, he immediately embraced him. And then both of them were releasing each other's association. And then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Ramananda Raya to sit and then asked him about the goal of human life. Though Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he knew everything, but still he wanted to hear from the mouth of Ramananda Raya, and in this way he actually wanted to teach the whole world that actually anyone who is conversant in the knowledge of Krishna, he can become guru, and we can listen from that person. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, kiva vipra kiva nyasi sudra kene nae jai krishna tatva veta sahi guru hai. So Ramananda Raya was born in a sudra family. Though he was born in a Sudra family, but he was a great learned scholar. And he was also a Rasik Bhakta who was relishing the mellow of devotional service. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to hear from Ramananda Rai. So Ramananda Rai, he said that I don't know anything, but whatever you will speak through my mouth, I will speak. That was the mood of Ramananda Rai. He was always taking the humble position. So then he started speaking about Varnashrama Dharma, and that was a long discussion, and we cannot discuss here. That would take a special class. The discussion took place between Ramananda Rai and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Ramananda Rai described in a gradual way about his past, spoke about Varnashrama Dharma. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, this is external, please speak more. So he was speaking that by Varnashrama Dharma, one can perform devotional service to please Lord Vishnu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not accept this. Then he said, karmarpana, that you offer the results of your activities to Krishna and satisfy Krishna. This is the goal of life. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, this is external. Please speak something more. And then Ramananda Rai said, to give up karma. This is goal of life, niskam karma. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, this is also external. Then he said, Jnana Mishra Bhakti is the goal of life. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, no, this is external. Then he said, Jnana Bihina Bhakti means Suddha Bhakti. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, this is all right. When he spoke about Suddha Bhakti, then only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, this is all right. Okay, speak something more. Then he spoke about Dasya Bhakti. Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya, Madhurya. So in this way, when he spoke about Madhurya Bhakti, in Madhurya Bhakti he spoke about Gopi Bhava, Gopi Bhava Bhakti, Kanta Bhakti. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, this is very good. When he spoke about Gopi Bhava, how to serve Krishna in the mood of the gopis. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, this is very good, but please speak more. Then Ramananda Rai, he said, among gopis, Srimati Radharani is the best. And to worship Krishna in the mood of Srimati Radharani is the best way of devotion. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, this is very good, when he spoke about Radharani's devotion. So this is the best way to serve Krishna. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked Ramananda Rai about Krishna Tattva and Radharani Tattva. So he spoke about Krishna Tattva and Radharani Tattva. Then he asked again more. So then at last, Ramananda Rai spoke about Manjari Bhav. The way the Manjaris, they serve the gopis and help Radha and Krishna in their pastimes. So in this way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he heard all these topics, he embraced Ramananda Rai. He was very happy to hear from Ramananda Rai this super most excellent confidential topics of Krishna, Radha Krishna bhakti, devotion to Radha and Krishna, which is the goal of life. So then, that day, night, Ramananda Rai left, then came next evening, and next evening also Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked different question to Ramananda Rai. So he asked what is the best knowledge? So there was some question answer session between Ramananda Rai and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was asking questions and Ramananda Rai was answering. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked what is the best knowledge, then Ramananda Rai answered that actually knowledge of Krishna, knowledge about devotional service to Krishna is the best knowledge, best vidya. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked about what is the greatest fame, kirti. So among all different fames, what is the best fame? So then Ramananda Rai answered that the best kirti of a person is who is famous as a Krishna bhakta. So Krishna bhakta or devotee of Krishna, this is the greatest fame of a person, if someone is a devotee of Krishna. Then he asked about what is the greatest wealth of a person. So then Ramananda Rai answered that who has love for Radha and Krishna, that is his greatest wealth. Who has love for Radha and Krishna? And then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked that what is the greatest misery? Then Ramananda Rai answered that when one feels separation from a devotee of Krishna, that is the greatest misery in life. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked, who is a liberated person in the material world? Then Ramananda Rai answered that who has become a devotee of Krishna, he is actually a liberated person. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked that what is the best song? Then Ramananda Rai answered that to sing about the pastimes of Radha and Krishna, that is the greatest song. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked that what is the greatest duty of a person in material world? Then Ramananda Rai answered that the person who associates with a devotee of Krishna, that is the greatest duty, to associate with a devotee of Krishna. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked that what should one remember in the material world? Then Ramananda Rai answered to remember the holy name of Krishna, his pastimes and his attributes. That is the greatest remembrance. If one remembers about Krishna's holy name, his attributes and pastimes. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked that what should one meditate upon? Then Ramananda Raya answered that one should meditate upon the lotus feet of Radha and Krishna. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked that where one should live in this material world. So then Ramananda Raya answered that where Krishna has performed his pastimes, that is Brajabhumi. One should live in Brajabhumi. So in this way, Ramananda Raya answered Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's questions, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very happy. And in this way, they discussed for 10 nights in the house of that Brahmana. And then when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, during that discussion, then one day Ramananda Raya told Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he said, "My dear Lord, I have a doubt in my mind. I want to clarify that doubt." Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, "Okay, you can clarify your doubt." Then Ramananda Raya said that actually I always see you as Shyama Gopa Rupa. I always see you, though you are a sannyasi with a golden complexion, but when I see you that you have a bluish complexion and you are a cowherd boy. So how is it that I see you as Krishna with bluish complexion and you are holding a flute and your eyes are very always moving? So your eyes are restless. So I want to know actually who are you?" Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu replied that actually you are a great devotee of Krishna. And a great devotee of Krishna, he sees Krishna everywhere. Sthavara jangama dekhe na dekhe tara murti, sarvatra hai tara ishta deva smurti. That a great devotee of Krishna, whenever he sees anyone, whether a living entity or whether a non-living object, so whatever he sees his worshipful Lord in everything. That's why, as you are a devotee of Krishna, that's why you see in everyone the form of Krishna. That's why you also see the form of same Krishna in me. So then Ramananda Raya said that, "My dear Lord, you cannot hide yourself from me. I can understand that you are the same Brajendra Nandana Krishna. And you have appeared in this golden complexion to release your own loving devotion. That's why you have accepted this complexion of Radharani, taking the mood of Radharani." So when Ramananda Raya told this thing to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu could not hide himself from his devotee. Then he said, that actually you have such loving devotion for me that I cannot hide from you. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu showed his original form as his Krishna form and at the same time Radharani's form. So when Ramananda Rai saw this, that how the bluish complexion Krishna is covered by the fair complexion of Srimati Radharani. Bahir Gaura Antah Krishna. So this outward complexion is Radharani's complexion of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And inside is Krishna himself, Antah Krishna, Bahir Gaura. So when Ramananda Rai saw this, that how Krishna has entered into Radharani's body and has taken the mood and complexion of Radharani. So Ramananda Rai immediately fainted. He could not resist himself. Though he was Visakha Sakhi, the constant companion of Radharani, but what was the cause of Ramananda Rai's fainting? Because Ramananda Rai had never seen Krishna entering into the heart of Srimati Radharani. This union of Radha and Krishna are of three types. One is Bhuta Milana, second is Bhavi Milana, and third is Bhavan Milana. So Ramananda Rai, in form of Visakha Sakhi, had seen Bhuta Milana and Bhavi Milana. Ramananda Rai had seen as Visakha Sakhi when Radha and Krishna united in Vrindavan, or going to be united, because Visakha was there making the arrangements for the union of Radha and Krishna. But Visakha had never seen Radha and Krishna uniting in her presence. Whereas in form of Ramananda Rai, now Ramananda Rai saw that how Krishna is entering into Radharani's heart and becoming, Radha and Krishna becoming one in Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, two in one. Radha and Krishna in one Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Radha Bhava Dhuti Suvalitam, Naomi Krishna Sarupam. That's why Ramananda Rai fainted. This is Bhavan Milan, which was happening in the eyes, in front of the eyes of Ramananda Rai. So in this way, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw Ramananda Rai has fainted, then immediately he touched Ramananda Rai with his hand. Then Ramananda Rai immediately got back his consciousness. And then Ramananda Rai told Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that please deliver me from this sansara andhakupa, I don't want to stay in this position anymore. I want to associate with you. So then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, that you give up this post of governorship, go to Jagannath Puri. After some time I will come back to Jagannath Puri, so we will both stay together and we will discuss Krishna Katha day and night at Jagannath Puri. So accordingly, Ramananda Rai gave up his government service and taking permission from Maharaj Pratap Rudra, he retired and came to Jagannath Puri and stayed with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and was helping Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by speaking Krishna Katha day and night and encouraging the mood of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So in another occasion, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he was at Jagannath Puri, Pradyumna Mishra came to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and told Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that I want to hear Krishna Katha from you. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, I don't know Krishna Katha. And when I want to hear Krishna Katha, I always go to Ramananda Rai. I hear Krishna Katha from Ramananda Rai. So if you want to hear Krishna Katha, then you go to Ramananda Rai and hear from him. Pradyumna Mishra was born in a Brahmin family. And Ramananda Rai was born in a Sudra family. So there is natural pride. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to teach lessons to his devotees, not only to Pradyumna Mishra, to all his devotees, brahmacharis and sannyasis, everyone. Because the brahmacharis and sannyasis, they think they are very renounced. And that pride is there in them. The brahmanas also think sometimes they are also very renounced. That pride is also there. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was teaching this lesson to his devotees through these pastimes. So he told Pradyumna Mishra to go to Ramananda Rai to hear Krishna Katha. But when he went to Ramananda Rai's house, Ramananda Rai was a householder, born in a Sudra family. So when he went to his house, his servant welcomed Pradyumna Mishra and made him sit in the assembly of Ramananda Rai. And he informed Pradyumna Mishra that, you please wait, Ramananda Rai is busy in some other work. And he said that Ramananda Rai he was training two young girls, two young unmarried girls who are very beautiful. So Ramananda Rai was training them how to dance and how to sing, so they could sing and dance in front of Jagannath. So Ramananda Rai had written one drama called Jagannath Vallabha. And he himself was training these girls how to sing the songs of that drama and dance and act accordingly in front of Jagannath. So then this servant informed Pradyumna Mishra that Ramananda Rai in the garden, in a solitary place, he was training these young girls how to sing and dance. So Pradyumna Mishra sat down for some time and it was late. When Ramananda Rai finished, then he heard that Pradyumna Mishra had come. So he went and apologized in front of Pradyumna Mishra that I did not know that you have come. No one told me. So I kept you waiting for so long. So I have committed an offense at your feet. Please forgive me. So what can I do? How can I serve you? Then Pradyumna Mishra did not tell anything. He only told that actually I had come for your darshan. So now I have got your darshan. I am very happy. And he came back. He did not tell anything to Ramananda Rai about Krishna Katha. So then next day when he went to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked Pradyumna Mishra, did you hear Krishna Katha from Ramananda Rai? Then Pradyumna Mishra described the whole episode. So then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu understood that Pradyumna Mishra had not understood Ramananda Rai properly. So Pradyumna Mishra might have thought that this person is a grihastha and he is training these young girls in a solitary place, bathing them, touching their body. So what to speak, how to hear Krishna Katha from such a person? So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to take away this doubt and feeling from the heart of Pradyumna Mishra and also at the same time from the heart of other devotees who would misunderstand Ramananda Rai, so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, in his own mouth, glorified Ramananda Rai. So he told Pradyumna Mishra, Kashta prasana sparse haye jaiche bhav, taruni sparse ramanander taiche svabhav. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that when someone will touch a piece of stone or a piece of wood, what would be his feeling? No feeling. So in the same way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, when Ramananda Rai would touch the body of a young girl, he would have this same feeling of touching a piece of wood and stone. No feeling, no transformation or no vikar. So this is the mood of Ramananda Rai. Sebya buddhe aropya karena sevana. So Ramananda Rai was serving these young girls and training them who dance and chant, sing in front of Jagannath in the mood of the gopis. Ramananda Rai was thinking himself as the servant of the gopis and these two young girls are the gopis. So sebya buddhi aropya karena saivan. Like the manjaris, we are serving the gopis and helping them to serve Radha and Krishna. So in the same way, in the mood of manjaris, Ramananda Rai was serving these young girls. Swabhika dasi bhava karena arapa. So Ramananda Rai was thinking the maid servant of the gopis. He was thinking himself as the maid servant of the gopis. And these young girls are the gopis and himself are the maid servant of them. So that's why no other feeling would come to his mind. that enjoying propensity would not be there. Then that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that this is the filling of Ramananda Raya. But I am a sannyasi. Amita sannyasi apanake virakta karimani. But I am a sannyasi, I myself think very renounced. But darsana rahu dure prakritira nama jadi suni. What to speak of seeing a woman? If I hear the name of a woman, tavahi vikar paaye mora tanuman. Just by hearing the name of a woman, my mind and my body, they are disturbed. Even if I am a sannyasi and thinking myself very renounced. Prakriti darsane. So that's why no one's mind would be peaceful just by seeing a beautiful woman. Eka devadasi are sundari taruni. But these two young girls whom Ramananda Rai was entertaining, teaching them, they were the devadasis. Devadasis were the young girls, unmarried girls, who had dedicated their lives, their body, mind and words for the service of Jagannath. So they were called devadasis. So these young girls were devadasis who would dance and sing for Jagannath. So they were young girls. And then Ramananda Rai was bathing these young girls, touching their body, but still he was unmoved. His mind would not be agitated by doing this. That was Ramananda Rai. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Nirvikara deha mana kastha pasana sama. Even if Ramananda Rai was touching the body of these young girls, bathing them, dressing them, putting garments on them, still his mind was undisturbed. He was undisturbed like touching a piece of wood and stone. That was his feeling. No other feeling was there. So, in this way, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu actually glorified Ramananda Rai, though he was a grihastha, a householder, Sudra, but still he was much greater than anyone, even greater than sannyasis in sense control. That was the mood of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So when Pradyumna Mishra heard this, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was glorifying Ramananda Rai in front of all the devotees, to teach all the devotees that they should not be proud that they are sannyasis or brahmacharis, and they are renounced. Because when they come in contact with women, their mind are generally disturbed. But Ramananda Rai's mind would not be disturbed, even if he was bathing and touching the body of young girls. So in this way, he was actually teaching all his devotees that how to respect Ramananda Rai, though he was Sudra, but he was so elevated in devotional service. So this was Ramananda Rai, whose disappearance day we are observing today, that how he actually associated with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and helped to develop the mood of Srimati Radharani when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was performing the pastimes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to release the mood of separation from Krishna. So we'll stop here, it is already late. Hare Krishna. Jai Sri Ramananda Rai ki, Jai Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki, Jai Gaura Bhakta Vrinda ki, Nitai Gaura Pramanande Hari Hari.